దిస్ సెషన్ ఈస్ అండర్ రికార్డ్ సో ఇది అయిపోయిన తర్వాత కూడా మీరు యాక్సెస్ చేసుకోవచ్చు ఈ సెషన్ని సో ఫార్మల్లీ స్టార్టింగ్ గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ టు ఆల్ ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ వై డస్ ఇట్ మ్యాటర్ ఓకే ఇట్స్ నాట్ జస్ట్ అన్ ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ ఇట్స్ ది నీడ్ ఆఫ్ ది అవర్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద టాపిక్ వీ హావ్ చూసన్ టు డిస్కస్ సమ్ థింగ్స్ the journey of a community's experience we want to share and tell you what is the role and what is the need of free software so I don't want to take much on the time on the definition of free software so if you need more explanation on the definition of free software please let me know in the public chat so defining with the four freedoms freedom to use as per your wish freedom to share distribute to your friend freedom to redistribute the modified like if you do any modifications you should be able to or you should have the freedom to share the copy and also you should be able to share the copy of the modified version let us say you know what was the most trending thing happened to many of the people or most of the people of my age during lockdown was so people started to learn cooking okay so I have seen a video on YouTube and I started to cook a dish okay so I felt like I don't like so and so ingredients so I have added different ingredient to it and I made another video okay so which would be tasting very good to the people who like the taste what I like also okay so you this is simple as as simple as a dish you make where you show your ingredients and you show the process of making it and make other people to build the same what you have so free software does not mean it's a cheap product or it is for free so that's why it's not going to have price and all so free is in the terms of freedom not in the terms of price even free software could get money by crowdfunding so have you ever downloaded VLC media player or Ubuntu have you ever downloaded these two or any of the free softwares Inkscape and all so how do you think they are earning money how do you think the free software that you have downloaded how they are earning money yeah Navya said she is downloaded the Ubuntu yeah so the communities are going to get like by crowd funds okay you can fund a free software community in order to support or in order to acknowledge the use of the free software but mostly we may not be able to fund for many reasons and most people do not fund but still they run okay you have seen Wikipedia's donation run recently right so all these communities that are formed by the people and for the people now let me come with a very small example a free software actually I said like a free software does not mean that it's a free thing okay a free software it's free means in the terms of freedom okay the way you use and the way you share and the way you own it okay I want to tell you one thing I've bought a proprietary operating system software and I tried to install Linux in parallel to that proprietary operating system then what happened is that didn't allow me to have two dual boot systems saying that it's one of the terms and conditions given by the manufacturer that it cannot have two operating systems having one proprietary thing then what I tried to do is I wanted to remove that Gemini operating system which I bought with some money and then I wanted to install it in my another computer say a desktop but it still didn't allow me because it is saying that the XYZ company's operating system is made for XYZ MAC address and it cannot be used I bought for some like 10,000 or 12,000 rupees but still I don't own the freedom of the software I don't have the freedom how to use it and where to use it okay so I have a desktop I don't want to use the that operating system on my laptop I want to use it on my desktop and I'm unable to do it okay so this is one freedom I found that I didn't get by the proprietary operating system okay now let me ask you some questions and make the story more clear to you how much time, how much cost does it involve to prepare one soap? To prepare one soap, how much cost does it involve? I mean, give me rough guesses, no problem. 30. 1550. Okay, on an average, let's say 30 rupees or 20 rupees is the cost of one soap. Okay, now what is the cost of manufacture, or what is the investment I need to do to manufacture or to make two soaps? If the cost is 15 or 20 rupees here, if 20 rupees is the cost to make one soap, to get two soaps, what is the cost? If 20 is for each one, what is the cost for two? Get the double, like 40. Three soaps. Yeah, please don't mind 20 table rice. The reason why I've asked it, it's a hardware thing. It has to be reproduced every time. The entire process of making a soap must be repeated. But now coming to the software thing, okay? To prepare one Hello World program, how much time and investment do you cost or do you charge? Three minutes. Okay, to print two Hello Worlds, okay, yeah, the answer was, you can just re-execute the program. You can share the program to your friend and he may re-execute the same and he may get the same answer. So to manufacture multiple copies of the same software, will it take more time than the single one? Right, simple copy paste, right? So it's not going to take much of investment. Okay, now this is one point I wanted you guys to remember. Okay, we'll discuss at the end of the session. So that's one point, and another point I want to bring before you. Free software anta worth kadu ani antama anukunnaru ikkada yes and message cheyandi. Free software is like okay, but not so competitive as proprietary. Soma Lakshmi has got answers. So Nitin and Tarak Swati got no. Yeah, it works good, but it is not for all purposes. It has limited purposes. Not all can use free software, right? So if you feel so, please type it here. If you agree with the statement what I said, please type yes. If you deny, please say no. Yeah, I'll respond with my answer even at the last. Right. Let me run a poll. That's a better way, right? If you agree with my statement, like free software is okay, but it's not so good as proprietary. Okay. So if you agree with the statement, press yes. If you deny, press no. Or if you have any other answer, you may press no. So 30 out of 56 participants have voted. So we are waiting for all of you to vote. 40 out of 56 have voted. Yeah. So, Tapasvi, Silasya, Niharika, we are waiting for your responses, Sanjana. Neeraj, Nagamalli, Vivek, Priyanka Chaudhary, Kalyani, Jangvi, and Dynamic Chaitanya, and Anjali. Yeah. So I got some results out of 46 people have voted. Then I'm sharing you the results. 33% of the participation, okay, have voted yes. I mean, you are agreeing with my statement, right? Now let me tell you what is the reality. This is the myth we had. Okay. Now let me tell you what is the reality of the free software and how does this free software work actually? Okay. Is it better than a proprietary or not? Let me see some public chat and. Let me ask you a question, like, what is the programming language that is trending now? Or what is that one programming language that made everything simple or programming simple? Python, Java. Yeah. Right. Yeah. So if you take the Python programming language, 33% of the industry is using the Python programming language. Okay. The main target of Python programming language is what you think is what you type. Okay. Like if you want to print something, say just print something. No need to say percentage F or percentage T. Yeah. Anaconda is a part of Python. Anaconda is made, is a library of Python programming language. Thanks for reminding the money. Okay. So then why not any proprietary programming languages being used? Do we have any? So yeah. Okay. Yeah. Now one simple example I want to bring before you again. Yeah, right. So coming back to the point of the example, right? So the example of free software is very simple. Like, do you want to help your friend or not is the point. You always tend to help your friend or not? Yeah. So the very first point I want to tell you that if you could help your friend, you have to help him, right? So that's how we evolve. Okay. If you go back to the evolution of the humans, how did human evolve? Okay. Humans started to learn skill from the environment they live in. Then they started to share how to use them. And then the communication has evolved and people started to communicate with each other. And then I have an idea, I share with you. You think the idea in same point of view, you let it grow. And others also started to think on the same idea and the idea grew up at the end of the day. So that is how we have come to today's society. Okay, that is the evolution point we have come into the society. The first myth I want to clear is, so free software, 90% of the, or 95% of the softwares, free softwares are used by the major servers that are running internet today. Do you agree with this point or not? Like Linux is one of the major operating system you find always that runs all these servers like Google, Netflix and whatever. Right? Yeah. Now, why these guys are looking at that? For example, say, if I give you a web project or if I give you a project of making a, say, simple calculator, what do you do? You write each and every operation again from the first, or you would like to prefer the stabilized work of somebody and extend the features of the calculator? What do you prefer? Create from scratch or reuse some modules? Yeah, so reuse or extend. So that's what the point is all about, okay? Right. So in free software, you will be free to reuse or extend the actual point that has created. Let me tell you the journey of one such software we built, one community has built. Okay. Let me run a poll and ask you a question. Have you heard about BalaSwitcher before? Have you heard about BalaSwitcher before? Now, let me introduce Balswecha for those, okay, who don't know it much. Once upon a time, long ago, I mean, maybe in 2010 or 11, one of the students that is studying a college said, like, by witnessing all the digital education we have now, he said, like, if this kind of digital education is available in our school days, I think it would be very better for all the people to learn the subject easy and innovate something new. Then we have talking to him, he said, like, he's from a underprivileged or government school where their facilities are very low and the teachers still use the traditional methods to teach the subjects. Then a set of volunteers in that community have came forward to address the problem of that fellow friend in that community. Okay. Then they started to create an operating system that contains the applications that are needed to learn the subject at school level. Okay. Just imagine we have the digital tools today available to few corporate schools. I mean, for the schools who can invest on software, the software is available to those schools. Okay. In turn, they are they're not giving, or the digital tools are not available to most of the people, right? So these guys have started to develop an operating system called as Bala Swecha. Okay. So the community Swecha started to build a children's operating system where the children can learn the digital, learn the subject through digital tools. Okay. Then during that evolution of Bala Swecha, I wanted to quote one statement I felt like yesterday through my experience, that free software that does just not build only a software. Free software builds a character. Free software builds your thought process. Free software does not just give you a piece of software. Along with that, it gives you a progressive thought process. Now I'll explain how this happened. Okay. So during the evolution of process, 2 to 3 people have come forward. Okay. And you think it's really possible if 1 or 2 people among us come forward and take an initiative, will that be success? Do you think so? మనలో ఒకళ్ళు ఇద్దరు వచ్చి ఈ ఐడియా ఇంప్లిమెంట్ చేద్దాము అంటే అది సక్సెస్ అవుద్దా? ఈ సెషన్ ముందు మీరు ఒక వీడియో చూసారు కదా, పీపుల్ అబౌట్ పీపుల్ హూ ఇన్స్పైర్డ్ స్వేచ్ఛ అని. ఓకే, సో అమంగ్ దోస్ పీపుల్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ ఫాట్, ఐ మీన్ స్టార్టెడ్ దేర్ ఫైట్ ఇండివిజువల్లీ. ఓకే, nobody has gathered a team and started the work. They started the work and people joined that work. Okay, so Mr. Mani, I'll tell about myself at the end of the session, so please be a little patient. I'll come back to your question, right? So coming to this point, every individual problem is started by an individual and then it is addressed by a set of people. If you think that it's not going to be possible, okay, ante na uddesham akada Uma Devi, it's not that only one will start, one will end. One will start the work and everyone has to join. Has to join ela jarugutadi ante, free software has to inspire people. The idea has to inspire the people around you. Okay. So the free software is not just a software development model. It's a social model. Okay. It's a social model. How should the society or our environment should build around, right? So vokalta start ayina oka journey. It started to include the BTech final year people, okay, students. So students have come forwarded while chadukuntunna basic web technologies gaani, programming gaani kuda ivanni kuda include chesi, they started to turn out the application idea to reality. Now just believe this, the students of 6th class, 7th class helped the Bala Swecha team to deliver the content. Okay, one chemical student Swecha volunteer started to give data like teluguloni kavulu kavithalu untai kada, poems and poets. He started to collect the data of poems and poets and he gave to the team of the Bala Swecha, and then the Bala Swecha team has taken the data and converted that into an application. Okay, so chemical student, what he has to do with a software? Okay, or 6th class, 7th class student, what he has more important than his homework? But why these guys came out of their comfort zones and gave a data to this software? Okay, so in that process we understood that free software, I mean the aim towards building a free software made us to learn that thing what Chandrika has typed. Okay, in the process of making a free software, we are learning and we are sharing. Okay, so this cycle has happened every time. Okay, learning and sharing. So this is the approach of making a free software. It's not just creating a software technically. It is preparing the people philosophically. Okay, so the philosophy of free software says you this: learn, share, explore. Okay, then you understand the larger idea of the world. So in this process, the Balasubramanian operating system did not just bring a change in just one school. It brought the change for all the volunteers who have been a part of that project. Okay, Balasubramanian program alone tree ante Balasubramanian operating system is school ki iskelli install chesi kon apps ni pillaliki train chestu untaru. Aa process lo volunteers they started to explore themselves what they are doing, why they are doing, why this is needed. Then they started to know what to do and how to do. So in a free software community, when we grow and when we create a software, it's not only the person who is technically sound is mattered. The person who is having idea, the person who is having motivation also matters to all of us. That's the concept of free software making. Now in this point, yes, I agree to some of your points. As you said, that free software does not is not at the level of competition to a proprietary software. Okay, now I deny with some cases and I agree with some cases. I deny at some cases, like for example, the poster we have seen is made out of Inkscape. Okay, so the Inkscape is written out of Python libraries. So this is how the free software has been evolved, and there is no, I mean, that gives a very good quality of work that you get from a Illustrator, Adobe Illustrator. You can do all the things you can do more than Adobe Illustrator in Inkscape. And also you can write your own plugins using basic programming. You can write your own plugins and embed it into Inkscape and use them for your own purpose. Now let me tell you one of my friend's story. He's a wedding photographer. So always the challenge what he used to face is, like, he used to take the pictures of everyone in the function. Now extracting the people from the photos has been always a challenge. Now one of my students is writing a program, small plugin, which can extract the persons from that photo and can save into a separate image. Now just imagine what is the work it is going to be reduced. Can anybody type it here? Is that going to reduce the work of the wedding photographer or not? Writing a plugin that will extract the people from the photographs, people separately from the group photos. Yes, right? Yeah. Now, this is the level of contribution you can make through a free software. I don't think we have an opportunity except requesting the Adobe community to develop a plugin of such. Okay. If that's not going to be a very good business strategy, like if Adobe Illustrator or Adobe Photoshop, if it's not going to attract the people or the customers, not the people. Okay. It's not going to attract its customers in view of this kind. Like if I don't provide this people extraction, people don't use Photoshop. So if there is such condition, then he's not going to do, because it's not important for his revenue model. But for a free software, people are not customers. People are part of the software. Okay. So in that process, I deny the statements that proprietary softwares are better than free softwares. And I agree in that context where you take a video editing tool. Okay, you have Adobe Premiere Pro, and we have Kden Live in free as a free software alternative. But I honestly say it does not match the actual rendering of the video. 2D linear video editing, Premiere Pro is best than Kden Live here. But still, the community is identifying all the different flaws that are faced during the usage of Kden Live. Okay, so that they can be addressed and can be solved and updated into the new version. So this continuous update is going in the free softwares. So I accept that statement that proprietary softwares are better than free softwares in the context of few free softwares that are still under construction. Okay. Now, hope I have cleared that point. Are you guys clear with the point number one about the myth of proprietary software versus free softwares? Now, when I was interacting with my wedding photographer friend, he was simply shocked. అసలు ఇలా అవుతుందా మనం ఇంత ఆటోమేటిక్గా పీపుల్ని ఫోటోల నుంచి బయటికి తీసుకురావచ్చా అని. ఇమేజ్ ప్రాసెసింగ్ చాలా అప్లికేషన్స్ లో ఉన్నాయి. ఇలాంటి అప్లికేషన్ ఉంటుంది అని కూడా ఎవరికి తెలియదు. బట్ ఈ కమ్యూనిటీ ఎవరైతే పీపుల్ దగ్గరగా పనిచేస్తామో దెన్ ఇట్ విల్ బి ఈజీ ఫర్ దెమ్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై ది యాక్చువల్ యూజర్స్. యా yeah, thanks for the responses. I just want to confirm my voice. Am I audible to you all in good volume, or shall I increase my volume? Yes, audible. Thank you. So I'm also speaking a little loud. Am I making any kind of boring, or are you bored of anything? I'm increasing also. Is the session going boring? Yeah, thank you. Please let me know if any example is making your understanding complex. Inka confusion create chestunnante, you can type in the public chat, then I could respond and I can change my example also. Yeah. I request everybody to respond in the public chat. Yeah. Now, the myth number one, what we have discussed, is proprietary software lu toplu, free software lu andarki panikiravu ani. So enduku panikiravu ante konni under construction lo unnai kaani last longing running race undi. Okay, running race lo velthunappudu oka free software inte panje, I mean oka proprietary software inte panje chestadi kaani free software develop chestunappudu you, if you are a part of that community and you can develop something, it can cross that line, it can cross that line and go beyond your ఇమాజినేషన్. ఓకే, సింపుల్ గా చెప్పాలి అంటే పైథన్ అన్నది, పైథన్ ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ లాంగ్వేజ్ అన్నది ఒక కంప్యూటర్ లో అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటివ్ టాస్క్లు చేయడానికి వాడారు. ఓకే, నౌ ఇట్ హాస్ బికమ్ అ జనరల్ మల్టీపర్పస్ లాంగ్వేజ్. యూ కెన్ డూ ఇమేజ్ ప్రాసెసింగ్, యూ కెన్ డూ మల్టీమీడియా, యూ కెన్ డూ మొబైల్ అప్లికేషన్, యూ కెన్ డూ డెస్క్టాప్ అప్లికేషన్, యూ కెన్ డూ వెబ్ అప్లికేషన్, సో అండ్ సో. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ఎయిమ్ టు డెవలప్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎయిమ్ టు డెవలప్ అ సింపుల్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటివ్ టాస్క్ ఆటోమేషన్. ఓకే, by Rasan. But today it has evolved into a very large general purpose, like everybody can use it. Okay, so that is the first myth. Now second myth I want to show you. Yeah, can you see the selected line in the presentation? So one of my colleagues or most of the teachers or the people in academia or the people in the industry who are not aware of free software usually debate one point. Free software ante code andariki accessibility lo untadu kada, so anybody can do anything kada, so anybody can easily hack or anybody can destroy the system ani oka myth untundi. How many of you believe it? Again, I run a poll, please respond in the poll that free softwares are easy to attack, are easy to destroy, are easy to hack. I repeat the question, free softwares are easy to attack. Code under the ground undi kabatti easy ga attack cheyochu, so people will be losing their data easily or hack ayipothe easy ga. I request everybody to please be active. Okay, I'm not naming any kind of specific Linux operating system. You take Ubuntu, Xubuntu, Debian or Kali Linux, Linux, I mean, all this belongs to the free software family, right? Yeah, I'm publishing the answers. Now for those who have accepted my statement or agreed with me, I want to clear you something. How many of you heard about ransom virus? RANSOME, ransom virus. Yeah. Did it attack any Linux operating system? Have you heard about that? Have you heard about the story? How did it start? Yeah, the older versions of a proprietary software has been taken and it has been created as an update to the operating system, and the intruders have come. Now, does Linux operating system or does any free software operating system require any antivirus? Now let me clear you this question. What is the definition of virus? A simple definition of virus. I want the most creative people to answer here. Not the three idiots virus, a computer virus. Yeah, between your answer, I want to say what is ransomware. Ransomware is going to encrypt the data and you have to give some money to the hacker to release your data. Else it's going to erase. I mean, you need to erase the data if you're not going to pay the hacker. Yeah, coming back to the definition of virus. What is virus? As simple as possible, please define. A thing which interrupts the usage of a particular data or application. Okay. I need more simpler than this, Nathan. More simple definition. Something which spoils, okay. Create a destroy in a data of computer. Okay. It is a thing which will eradicate or erase the data, malicious code or program, unwanted things, data breach, corrupts the application. For example, say I wanted to share what happened to me yesterday. I was traveling from Vijayawada to Vijayanagaram. So suddenly my driver forgot the route and he had taken some wrong street. Okay, he found a dead end. Okay, I was intended to go. My actual program of my journey is to go to Vijayanagaram. But due to something happened with the driver or the route, I have been misguided to some other place. So simply an analogical example of virus is this. Okay, that disturbs the flow of execution. Or a virus is nothing but a self-executable file. It can execute anything. Like you guys mentioned here, it may erase your data, it may corrupt the software, it may corrupt the operating system, it may have data breach. Okay, all these things are execution part. But if a program is running without your consent in your computer, then it's going to be harmful. Okay, even the program is written by your friend, if it is not asking your permission to run, it is going to be harmful. Okay, so in Linux, every execution needs your password. Every installation of a software needs your password. Password does not mean yes or no. Like you see on some proprietary operating systems, it is going to ask you the password that you give to your computer. That means you are consciously checking every installable on your computer and make sure that no virus is going to attack your system. Okay, so that's the thing I wanted to say about the virus thing in free software or Linux. And if you take Linux or any Linux operating system, a Linux is not built by one person or two persons or a set of people at one country or one place. It is developed by the people across the globe. Okay. Where we have the day they sleep and they have the day we sleep, but everybody is going to work on the stability of the operating system. Like the point I said, like free software is open to all, so there will be some security threats. A community is not a simple team of people. A community is a hierarchy of people, like a flat hierarchy of people where you'll have all the checks. Before something is inserted as an update to an operating system or to any software, the team has to approve your change. Okay. If you want to say Inkscape ki oka plugin rasanu antanu kinda example icham kada, to extract the people from the photographs, I've written a plugin for Inkscape. If the Inkscape community feels that this is an update, I have to give it to all the Inkscape users, then they'll approve your update and then they'll attach to the Inkscape. So thereafter, whoever installs Inkscape will get your plugin. Ledu Inkscape standards ki match avaledu ante, you can use it on your local system and you can share it to your friend on the internet. Okay, install this for your Inkscape on your computer. So these are the two ways where people start developing the code. If half the globe is going to set the virus, half the globe is there to defend the virus. So there are different levels of checks before anything is kept into the software as an update. So that's the point which defines the free software to be most secure than any other operating system. Okay, that's the reason why all the servers are interested to run on Linux, not on any other free software things. Okay, so that's the second myth. So free software is only for developers. That's another myth we have. And I'm trying to clear you by the point that free software is not just used to develop softwares. Okay, can you please respond me why we need to use free software? What does it develop along with the software? like in the process of or some of you have voted for balls which are already known. So if you have participated in any of the activities, okay, what did you observe that are built along with the software? Yeah, I'm waiting for your responses in the public chat. What are the things that will be built along with the free software? Viruses are built, Nitin? Actually, no. To use free software is to make a political and ethical choice, asserting the right team to learn and share what we learned with others. We can give some extra features.
Yeah.
So in that process, your thought process would be increasing. That's what I'm expecting as a response here. When you develop a free software, along with the software, the mindset of the people, the abilities of the people contributing to the software will increase. Okay. Right. Now, the last myth I want to discuss. See, the reason I'm not discussing the definitions of free software is like, it's already available on the internet. If you go to Google or go to Wikipedia and search what is free software, it's going to give you the definition. But today, we are conducting this session or this podcast or this webinar for that one reason. We wanted to say, why does that actually matter? Okay. Why do you need to choose free software when I'm getting ready-made software? So why I need to go to this thing? That's the reason I'm talking in point of view the myths. I wanted to think in the opposite stream and understand what is the philosophy of the free software. That's what I'm trying to make in this session. Okay. So if you see the selected thing on the screen, it supports only command line interface. I want to share one of my crazy experiences. One of my MTech students is using she needs a mail send, she needs to send a mail to her guide immediately, and there is no system available around there. So she came to me and she asked her for a help to send a mail to her guide. So what I've done is I've given my system her to her to just to send a mail to her guide. Then she sat in the chair. She is starting for searching the browser. Then she immediately got up and said, oh my god, it's Linux. Because there is a myth in her mind that Linux should only be operated by command prompts. Without command prompt, Linux cannot run. This is the myth people usually have. Linux vaadalante kachithanga neeku 10 command lu telisi undali ani oka apohamallo undi. So if you are a developer, you may use it. If you are not a developer, if you are a general user, if you are a basic user or a layman user, you can still use the computer, Linux computer. Okay. So the user friendliness has been added and is being added from last many years to Linux operating system, and which to my experience as I've used both the operating system, I've not used only one, and I'm saying about the both. Okay. I know PowerShell and also I know the terminal. Okay. By comparing these two, I'm saying you my opinion that Linux operating system felt me more live. Okay. I never felt like my computer is a machine that is helping me. For the reason, the interactions between the window switching or the fonts or the kind of user interface I have, I never felt like it's a computer. I need to do some commands and all. At most of the times, I try not to interact with the commands for the reason I wanted to learn whether Linux can be used without commands or not. And yes, I got a result positive that you can use the Linux operating system without any kind of commands. And if you use commands, you can do something else. I mean, you can explore more things. But if you want to simply use a computer, you can use it through the Linux things. Okay. Right. Now, this is the point I'm really shocked, and I wanted to ask you. 78% of the companies run on open source and free software. Asala free software to business run cheyacha? Can free software be used for business? How? You're saying you should share it to your friend. Okay. You're saying that ready-made ga unna modules ni use cheskuni nen calculator ni extend chestan antunnaru kada. Can you do business? This is one of the major myths people have, that free software cannot be it cannot be used to do business. Okay, but let me tell you, free software is made by many people, right? Or it could be made by many people. You may start, if me, Uma Devi, Selvaraj, Nitin, Swati are starting the calculator application, I write addition operation and leave it in the GitHub or GitLab. Then Uma Devi is going to fork that. She is going to add subtraction. Selvaraj will add multiplication. Nitin will add product. Tarak Swati will add some memory to that application. So in total, my addition operation have become a very big arithmetic calculator now. Okay. So who is the owner of the product? Who is the owner of the product? Me. I just started, but it didn't do anything, right? If I have to own the thing, I have only my addition operation. Yes, everybody is going to be the owner of the product. So how can you sell the product? How can you as an individual sell the product? You cannot sell it as a product to anybody, because it's the work of many people, okay, with the motto of learn and share, with the idea of free software. Then how to do business? You can actually do business by the services of the calculator. If you are developed of any free software, you can say, for these many calculations, I charge these many rupees. Okay, for addition operation, 2 rupees. For subtraction operation, these many rupees. This is how you can generate or create a revenue model out of free software. Okay, and remembering the point that the philosophy of free software says that the product and software is not a product to be sold. Like the example we are discussing in the starting stage of this webinar, it's not a soap. It's a software, okay? It does not take any new investment to create another copy, right? Therefore, what you can do, you can create a service. You can create a service, you can add a service to that software, and you can sell it or you can make money out of it, okay? That's one point I wanted to clear during today's webinar. Can be sold by anyone, yeah. The services, the software cannot be sold again, woman. Okay, the calculator services can be sold. I cannot say calculator is 100 rupees. I can sell the services of calculator. Like I host the calculator. If Sriram wants to use the calculator, Sriram, you pay this much. Okay. If Gayatri wants to use subtraction, Gayatri, you pay me this much. Okay. Nobody can sell the software. Now, let me tell you, in this pandemic, almost all the colleges are trying to shift to virtual classrooms, right? సో వర్చువల్ క్లాస్ రూమ్స్ కి వెళ్తున్నప్పుడు మనం ఇక్కడ మన ఎంఎస్ టీమ్స్ మీదో జూమ్ మీదో ఎక్కడో డిపెండ్ అవుతూ ఉంటాం. ఓకే, సో దెన్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ మనీ ఈస్ బీంగ్ ఇన్వెస్టెడ్. నౌ ఐ వాంటెడ్ టు షేర్ వన్ ఆఫ్ మై ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్ వైల్ ఐఎమ్ యూజింగ్ ఎంఎస్ టీమ్స్. ఓకే, ఐ నీడ్ అ పోల్ ఆప్షన్. డూ యూ థింక్ పోల్స్ ఆర్ గుడ్ ఆర్ బ్యాడ్? ప్లీజ్ ఆన్సర్ దిస్ పోల్. పోల్స్ వెన్ లర్నింగ్ ది క్లాసెస్ ఆన్లైన్ helps you or don't helps you? If it helps you, go for yes. Polls petna kuda laabham ledra anukunte no bet andi. Yeah, so that's the answer you have, right? So in MS Teams, I have to install an additional plugin. Okay, to ask you some questionnaire, I need to install another thing that may not be free for me, that may charge some money to me. Okay, so that's the point we had. Now what we have done is we have forked the Moodle. Moodle's instance. Moodle is a learning management system. Okay, so have you ever visited courses.svecha? So courses.svechaap.org, okay, is a learning management system of Svecha. If you are going to be a part of any workshop or Svecha, you will be given an account there. Okay, it will have all the materials hosted, assignments hosted, whatever, all the things that are required to take a class, all the things are there inside the tool. Now, what we did is we have added some more components according to the requirement of the organization, Switcher needs so and so, so we have installed so and so. And then we have given a service to that college. Okay. Now it has empowered its own faculty, its own students to create an own tool for their own college. Now, this has created an opportunity for the students and also for the faculty or any researcher to build, softwares for their own organization instead of depending on any other thing. వాడు ఎప్పుడు అప్డేట్ ఇస్తాడా, వాడు ఎప్పుడు దాన్ని యాడ్ చేస్తాడా అని ఎదురు చూసే కంటే వీళ్ళే వీళ్ళ సర్వీసెస్ని యాడ్ చేసుకోగలిగారు. ఇందాక బాలస్విచ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్తున్నప్పుడు కూడా సాఫ్ట్వేర్ మనం రాయిలా, అంటే సాఫ్ట్వేర్ మనం రాస్తుంది, డేటా ఎవరు ఇస్తున్నారు, ఒక 6th class 7th class స్టూడెంట్ డయాగ్రామ్ ఫ్రూట్స్ లేదా నేషనల్ లీడర్స్ది ఇచ్చాడు డేటా. సో ఒక స్టూడెంట్ కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్తోనే ఆ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ తయారు చేసాం. ఇఫ్ ఇన్ ఫ్యూచర్ వాట్ వీఆర్ ఎయిమింగ్ ఈస్ వీ వాంటెడ్ ద టీచర్స్ టు బిల్డ్ ది సాఫ్ట్వేర్. ఎందుకంటే ఎవ్రీబడి షుడ్ బి సెల్ఫ్ డిపెండెంట్, ఎవరో వస్తారని కాదు. ద మోటో ఆఫ్ బీయింగ్ అ టీమ్, అ కమ్యూనిటీ ఇన్ ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఇస్ టు ఎంపవర్ ఎవ్రీబడి. ఓకే, వంశీ ఏదో చేస్తాడు, ఎప్పుడు వస్తాడు అప్పుడు చేస్తాడని వెయిట్ చేయకుండా వంశీ వచ్చే లోపల నేను ఏం చేయగలను అని ఒకరిని ప్రతి ఒక్కరిని కూడా సెల్ఫ్ ఎంపవర్ చేయడమే కమ్యూనిటీస్, ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ కమ్యూనిటీస్ యొక్క మెయిన్ ఎయిమ్. ఓకే, సో ఇక్కడ ఈ పరిస్థితుల్లో ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ని స్టార్టప్స్ ఎలా వాడతారు అంటే మనకి ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ తక్కువ ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సే ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు స్టార్ట్ అ స్టార్టప్ బై మూడుల్, మూడుల్కి కొన్ని ఎక్స్ట్రా సర్వీసెస్ వేసుకుని నేను ఏ ఆర్గనైజేషన్కి అయితే చేస్తున్నానో ఐ కెన్ మేక్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అ స్టార్టప్. ఫర్ దిస్ ఐఎమ్ ఐ పర్చేసింగ్ ఎనీ మూడుల్, బట్ వాట్ కెన్ ఐ డూ ఈస్ ఐ కెన్ కాంట్రిబ్యూట్ బ్యాక్ టు ద మూడుల్ ఇన్ మై ప్రాఫిట్ షేర్. ఓకే, సో మోడల్ కమ్యూనిటీ ఆఫ్ డెవలపర్స్ ఎవరైతే ఉన్నారో వాళ్ళకి నా షేర్స్లో నుంచి కొంత నేను ఇవ్వచ్చు. ఓకే, సో దట్ ఈస్ హౌ దే యాక్చువల్లీ గ్రో, రైట్? ఐఎమ్ నాట్ పర్చేసింగ్. సో మై ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ ఇన్ మై కంపెనీ ఈస్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ జీరో వెన్ ఐఎమ్ యూజింగ్ ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు ది సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ ఇన్ మై కంపెనీ. ఓకే, దట్స్ వై యూ కెన్ సి మేజర్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టార్ట్అప్ స్టార్ట్ విత్ ది ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్. ఓకే, దెన్ దే ఎవాల్వ్ టు రైట్ వన్ మోర్ ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ అండ్ దెన్ distributed to the people. Yeah. Yeah, everybody, how many of you are near to calculators? Please respond yes or no. One final calculation that will close the session. Yeah. So please type your answers here. Okay. Now, this is one part. Now, the part, the financial investment on the proprietary softwares. Okay. What is the cost of Microsoft Windows operating system 10, version 10? You can check Amazon or you can check all the people who are looking at you. 10,000. Okay, let's say I give it to Rajiv for 8,000. Okay, so 8K. What is the cost of Microsoft Office 365? Microsoft Office. Let us say 3K. Let us use JDK, Jali Daya Karna, and see what is going to happen. What is the cost of an antivirus for 1 year subscription? Cost of antivirus for 1 year subscription. Okay, I say 500 on JDK basis. What else we require? Microsoft operating system, Microsoft Office tools, Microsoft antivirus. Okay. Okay. These are the basic things we consider. What is the total of all these? Total of all this. 8,350. Okay. Okay. Again, I'm applying JDK. What is JDK? You understand the terms Jali Daya Karuna, right? Hey, Nitin, it's not Java Development Kit this time. It's Jali Daya Karuna. Jali. Sympathy. 8,000 రూపీస్ కి ఫైనల్ గా డీల్ ఫిక్స్ చేశాను బాస్ నీతో. ఓకే, ఒక 8,000 రూపీస్ నువ్వు నాకు ఇస్తే ఒక విండోస్ 10 ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్, ఓకే, ఒక ఆఫీసు. ఐమ్ సారీ, ఇట్స్ నాట్ 8,350, రైట్? యా, 11,000 అనుకుందాం. ఐ గెట్ 500 రూపీస్ ఆల్సో ఆఫ్. నౌ అ స్కూల్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు హ్యావ్ 10 సిస్టమ్స్, ఓకే. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ గవర్నమెంట్ ఆన్ వన్ స్కూల్? If I'm going to have one systems, investment of our government on one school for a software, full-fledged software. Okay, మీరు నాకన్నా ఎక్కువ జాలి దయ కరుణ చూపిస్తున్నారు. రైట్, 1 lakh. ఓకే, వీ హ్యావ్, ఓకే, ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఒక డిస్ట్రిక్ట్కి ఎన్ని స్కూల్స్ ఉన్నాయని మీరు అనుకుంటున్నారు? హౌ మెనీ స్కూల్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఫర్ అ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్? ఒక జిల్లాకి ఎన్ని పాఠశాలలు ఉండొచ్చు? 500. పాతిక, మై గాడ్. యు గైస్ నీడ్ టు విజిట్ ద ఫీల్డ్ ఇమీడియట్లీ. ఓకే, దెర్ విల్ బి మోర్ దాన్ 1,000. ఓకే, ఐ హ్యావ్ ది స్కూల్స్ డేటా ఆఫ్ విజయనగరం డిస్ట్రిక్ట్. విజయనగరం డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ 13 డిఫరెంట్ మండల్స్. ఓకే, అగైన్ ఎవ్రీ మండల్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ మెనీ వార్డ్స్ అండ్ ఈచ్ వార్డ్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ వన్ స్కూల్. Okay, so what is the investment of our government on one district? Say if we have 1,000 schools in that district, 1 lakh into 1,000, how much? 1 crore. Okay, how many districts does our new state have? So how much on a state? 13 crores. How many states we have in India? 13 into 29. How much? 377 rupees, lakhs, crores, what are those? Yeah, that is an approximate investment of the government on the software. Okay, if you look into the presentation, the Kerala government saves 300 crores as schools switch to free and open source software. Okay, so that is the amount you are going to save for our country, which is already having very large financial problem. We have lowest GDP ever, and this situation is the right time for the country, India, to translate its digital resources to be very secure model into the free software model. Okay, now what are the challenges? I mean, do you agree with this or not? Do you agree with this point? Can the government save this set of money on purchasing the licenses? Yes. Now, point number two, if we have to implement it, what are the challenges? What are the challenges the present system is having? అంటే ఎస్, 300 కోట్లు మిగులుస్తున్నాను అనుకున్నప్పుడు మనకి ఛాలెంజెస్ ఏమి ఉండొచ్చు? ఫస్ట్, హౌ టు యూజ్ ద న్యూ సాఫ్ట్వేర్, ఇంటర్నెట్ ఫెసిలిటీస్. అసలు నా దగ్గర ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఈ ప్రపంచంలో ఎన్ని ఉన్నాయి, అసలు ఏమున్నాయి, వాట్ ఆర్ ద సెట్ ఆఫ్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్స్ ఐ కెన్ యూజ్, అవేర్నెస్. నౌ టెల్ మీ, ఈ 300 కోట్లు తీసుకెళ్లి ట్రైనింగ్ లో పెట్టే అనుకోండి, విల్ ఇట్ బి యూస్ఫుల్ ఆర్ వేస్ట్ఫుల్? ట్రైనింగ్ ఆల్ ద పీపుల్, ఆల్ ద సెట్ ఆఫ్ పీపుల్ హూ యూజ్ ద కంప్యూటర్స్, గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫీసెస్ లో కానీ, స్కూల్స్ లో కానీ, టీచర్స్కి కానీ, స్టూడెంట్స్కి కానీ పెడితే 300 crores వన్ టైం ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ అవుతుంది మనకి. ఆ నెక్స్ట్ ఇయర్ నుంచి అందరికి అలవాటు అవుతుంది. 1 ఇయర్ పాటు మనం 377 crores ఇన్వెస్ట్ చేస్తే పీపుల్ విల్ బి హ్యాబిచ్యుయేటెడ్ టు దాట్. You know, Linux is not difficult to use. Linux is lately introduced to you because of our schools and our education system. చిన్నప్పుడు ఎంఎస్ ఆఫీస్, ఎంఎస్ పెయింట్ నేర్పించారు, బట్ మనకు అప్పుడు తెలియదు కూడా తెలియదు అంటే ఆల్టర్నేటివ్ ఉంటుంది అని. ఇప్పుడు మనం ఏం ప్రయత్నిస్తున్నాం అంటే, వీ వాంటెడ్ టు టేక్ దిస్ సిస్టమ్, దిస్ క్రియేటివ్ సిస్టమ్, into the education of schools, colleges, and everywhere where you learn and study. Okay, ee process lo you are making the next generation people to habituate to Linux. చిన్నప్పటి నుంచి మనందరం గ్రీన్ గ్రాస్ బ్లూ స్కై చూస్తూ అలవాటు పడ్డాం. వాట్ ఈస్ గ్రీన్ గ్రాస్ బ్లూ స్కై? ఏం గుర్తొచ్చింది? గ్రీన్ గ్రాస్ బ్లూ స్కై ఎక్స్పి, ఎప్పుడైనా విన్నారా మీరు? మైక్రోసాఫ్ట్ ఎక్స్పి, యా, ఎక్స్పీస్ వాల్ పేపర్ ఈస్ గ్రీన్ గ్రాస్ అండ్ బ్లూ స్కై. చిన్నప్పటి నుంచి అందులో మనం ప్రాక్టీస్ చేస్తున్నాం కాబట్టి వచ్చింది. అండ్ యూ గైస్ డోంట్ నో that most of the people are not using the genuine operating systems. Okay, even meer vaadutundi genuine kaada ani meer kuda doubt undochu. If you are using a genuine operating system, check this point that you should have a piece of software to reinstall it on the same machine at least. Ante ivval keval and data corrupt ayipindi, are you able to install or reinstall the same copy of the software that you have bought? If not, yours is not genuine. I'll tell you my experience. I bought this laptop Dell, and then I bought this operating system for 12,000 rupees in those days, Windows 10. Okay, then I'm interested to use Linux, so I removed Windows and I installed Linux. And the other day when I was trying to install Windows, I didn't find my genuine copy and key. Then I called the Microsoft or the Dell help center that I bought something from you and I have a receipt of that purchase and I don't have a software of that. I demanded it and I literally finally got the DVD copy of my software, of my Windows 10 genuine key. Okay, so this is how you're abstracted from the actual original genuine software. That's one point you need to know. And if you are aware, most of the DTP centers, Photoshop's meeda kontha mandi attack chesaru, vilu piracy software lo vaadutunnaru, Windows piracy vaadutunnaru, ledante Photoshop piracy vaadutunnaru ani raiding jarigindi. అలాగే కొన్ని కాలేజెస్ మీద కూడా జరిగినాయి. వీడు మ్యాట్ ల్యాబ్ వాడలేదు, లేదా వీళ్ళు ఎక్స్పైర్ అయిపోయిన విండోస్ వాడుతున్నారు. యూ డోంట్ నో హౌ పీపుల్ విల్ రన్ బిహైండ్ ఆల్ ది సెట్టింగ్స్ ఆర్ ప్రిపేరింగ్ ది మనీ ఫర్ దర్ నెక్స్ట్ పర్చేస్ ఆఫ్ దర్ లైసెన్సెస్. ఓకే, ఆ కర్మ మనకి ఈ డిజిటల్ ఏజ్లో మనకు అవసరం లేదు, బికాస్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ హెస్ బికమ్ జనరిక్ టు ఆల్. సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఇస్ డస్ నాట్ జస్ట్ బిలాంగ్ టు సిఎస్సి ఆర్ ఐటి ఆర్ సంబడి స్పెసిఫిక్లీ. సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఇస్ దేర్ విత్ ఎవ్రీబడి. హూ ఈస్ నాట్ యూజింగ్ ఎంఎల్? ఏ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ వాళ్ళు ఎంఎల్ యూజ్ చేయట్లేదు? మెషిన్ లెర్నింగ్ ఆర్ ఆర్టిఫిషియల్ ఇంటెలిజెన్స్? ఏ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ వాళ్ళు పైథన్ కోడింగ్ చేయట్లేదు? ఏ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ వాళ్ళు ఐఓటీ వాడట్లేదు? ఎవ్రీబడి ఈస్ యూజింగ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ బికాస్ ద సాఫ్ట్వేర్ హ్యాస్ పెనిట్రేటెడ్ ఇన్ టు అవర్ డైలీ లైఫ్, రైట్? మన ప్రతి, నువ్వు ఏ ఇంజనీర్ కాదు, ఏ సైన్స్ స్ట్రీమ్ తీసుకో, దిస్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ కాంపోనెంట్ ఈస్ మేకింగ్ అవర్ లైఫ్ ఈజీ అండ్ ఎవ్రీబడి యూజెస్ ఇట్. ఆఖరికి కెమికల్ కాంపోజిషన్స్ టైమ్లీ కలపాలన్నా కూడా దే ఆర్ యూజింగ్ సమ్ ఇంటెలిజెంట్ మెషిన్స్ అల్గోరిథమ్స్ టు మిక్స్ ది కాంపోజిషన్స్. రిజల్ట్ని అనలైజ్ చేయడానికి కూడా వాళ్ళు కోడ్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ని యూజ్ చేస్తున్నారు. అండ్ ఎస్ ఉమా, ఇఫ్ యూ రిమెంబర్, యూఆర్ సీయింగ్ న్యూ యాడ్స్ బై సోను సూద్ అండ్ అదర్ పీపుల్ రైట్ నౌ, వైట్ హ్యాట్ జూనియర్ అండ్. కోడింగ్ చిన్నపిల్లలకి నేర్పించేంత ఈజీ అయింది వాళ్ళ, అంత జనరిక్ అవుతుంది పైథన్ లాంటి ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ లాంగ్వేజెస్ వల్ల. నా దిస్ ఈస్ ద హై టైమ్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్ టు జాయిన్ ది ఫ్రీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ కమ్యూనిటీస్ and start doing and learning and also sharing people the knowledge of the computers and software. Now let me tell you and conclude the point. If there is no free software in this world, what would happen? Because this is the matter, that matters most than all the other points I've said. One company will decide what movie you have to watch. One single company will decide what you have to eat. One company will decide what you have to where and what you, where you have to go and whom you have to hang out with. You got it right? What softwares I'm talking about? Can you list them there? Can you please list it out there? Prime. Who is the richest person in this world today? The Amazon guy, right? The reason is they have the data. I don't want to go much more on data. That's another big story, the big interesting story. If you felt this session to be interesting, that is much more interesting story. How do they steal the data and make business out of your data? And you can ask me, na shoe size na pant size to add gain rabaabu anukunte, that's what they are selling our data. Some companies are officially selling the data. Some companies are being looted for not giving the data. Okay. We'll discuss about the data point in the digital world later in next sessions. And I'm open for your questions. That's right, guys. You have listed all your the things what all happened there. Yeah, I'm open to your questions now. So that's what a free software matter to you. If that's not there in your life, you are going to miss yourself in your life, because you are just a product for a company. The product will decide what this user has to do. Okay, that is the threat we have in the digital age. So you need to be very cautious about that, and you should be ready for free software moments. We get some ads about the phone which we use. Yeah, obviously. Most of the short films I see are making memes out of it. Meme vachindi anamata. Brahmananda emo itla mobile edo chustu untadu. Madhile anukune amma odile malli ad vachestadi din gurinchi anukune aagipothadu. That's really not a joke. That's serious. That's the future. Like, nu em konali anadhi nen decide cheyestanu. Konen taraga nee ad ni rewind chestane untaru vallu. Targeting ad, personalized ads and pair with title antaru gaani. They're actually analyzing your data. Will humans go extinct if AI comes fully to us? Again, Sumant, ask a question to you. If I understand you completely, I travel with you for some 20 to 30 years, I understand you completely. Can you act before me? Can you be yourself with jolly ga undagalva? You cannot, because you know that I'm watching your every step. And ఇప్పుడు ఇలా అన్నానంటే అడిగి తెలిసిపోద్ది, నేను బిహేవ్ చేస్తున్న ప్యాటర్న్ అడిగి తెలిసిపోద్ది అని చెప్పి, యుల్ నాట్ బి ఫ్రీ, యుల్ నాట్ బి ఫ్రీ టు థింక్. ఇఫ్ ఏఐ కమ్స్ ఆర్ నాట్, ఇఫ్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డిజిటల్ ఏజ్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు కంటిన్యూ, దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు హ్యాపన్. యూ స్టాప్ థింకింగ్, యూ విల్ సింప్లీ యూజ్ ద థింగ్స్, యుల్ నాట్ థింక్ హౌ టు యూజ్ ఆర్ వాట్ టు యూజ్ అండ్ వాట్ టు క్రియేట్. ద ఫ్యూచర్ ఇస్ ఫుల్ ఆఫ్ కోడింగ్ నౌ. Yes, computer runs on programs and programs are built by coding the programming instructions. So Madhavi, yes. And if anybody is interested to join, okay, we Swecha IP are celebrating the Software Freedom Day for a week till October 2nd. If anybody is interested to join and know about these many more things, we are running a campaign of free software and alternative softwares, okay, where you can explore, you can follow us, you can give the data to us. For example, say Photoshop, on the Photoshop alternative enti man free software lo. Jim, okay, yeah. So yeah, I'll answer every question. So this is the campaigning we are going to run. Okay, from today onwards, we are going to reach one poster. Each poster will contain the daily used software by all of us which is harmful to us, and we'll also give an alternative software. By replacing that software, you can use the data, you can be stay safe on the digital world. Now coming to the question of, does Swecha has Discord server? Swecha runs all of its services on its own server. Can you see this meetup applications where we are meeting around? This is a Swecha application running on the Swecha server itself. Okay, and also we have mail server @swecha.net. Okay, we have the mailing services, we have the courses. Okay, and then we have the say code labs, I mean the code repository. So can Nitin please explain me what is Discord? Between Nitin explains Discord, how a good AI should be used. See, goyya tavali ante soodi testara will use some crowbar, right? So AI ki elanti vaatliki vaadali ante, ఇక్కడ కరోనాను తగ్గించాలంటే స్ట్రాటజీస్ ఏంటి, కరోనా పెరగడం వల్ల పెరుగు, వాట్ ఆర్ ద రీజన్స్ దట్ ఆర్ ద యాక్చువల్ రీజన్స్ ఫర్ కరోనా టు స్ప్రెడ్, హౌ టు కంట్రోల్ దెమ్, ఇలాంటి వాడికి ఏఐ వాడాలి. అంతేగాని సుమంత్ రేపు షూ కొంటాడా, ఎల్లుండి సినిమాకి వెళ్తాడా, ఓకే రేపు డ్రింక్ తాగుతాడా, ఇప్పుడు స్విగ్గీలో ఏం కావాలి, ఈ అప్లికేషన్స్కి ఏఐ యూజ్ చేస్తే ఇట్స్ అప్ టు దెమ్ హౌ డు దే యూస్. దే సర్వ్ యూ పర్సనలైజ్డ్, బట్ this is not the right place for them to use. The right place is always different. పావర్టీ పోగొట్టాలంటే పావర్టీ ఎందుకు వస్తుంది, ఒక పర్సన్ పూర్ ఎందుకు అవుతాడు, పావర్టీ సొల్యూషన్స్ ఏంటి, ఇలాంటివి కూడా ఏఐ తో ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేయొచ్చు. బట్ నోబడీ ఈజ్ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్. ఓకే, డిస్కార్డ్ ఈస్ ది ఈజియస్ట్ వే టు టాక్ ఓవర్ వాయిస్, వీడియో, టెక్స్ట్. యా, సో దిస్ ఈస్ బిగ్ బ్లూ బటన్ ఇన్స్టెన్స్. బిగ్ బ్లూ బటన్ అనేది సేమ్ డిస్కార్డ్ లాగే, లైక్ డిస్కార్డ్ డూస్ దట్, బిగ్ బ్లూ బటన్ డూస్ ద సేమ్. వీ హ్యావ్ టూ సర్వర్స్ రన్నింగ్ నౌ. Meetup is Big Blue and Jitsi is another instance of Swecha for voice calls. Okay, Mumble is another thing we have on mobiles also. You need to install Plumble and then type swecha.org, then you will be added to the radio of Swecha. So Nitin, am I clear to you? Uma Devi, future is full of coding. No, what is the scope of jobs for non-software people? I mean, you can become entrepreneurs. I would like to introduce a company, ThoughtWorks, okay, which is a very good company, MNC, and that runs, I mean, that develops the softwares, most of its softwares, through free software, okay? So, what is the scope of jobs for non-software people? See, మన డైలీ లైఫ్ లో ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ ఎంత కామన్ అవుతుందో, అంటే టెక్నాలజీని పక్కన పెడితే, ఇఫ్ ఎనీ పర్సన్, ఎనీ స్టూడెంట్ ఆర్ ఎనీ జాబ్ ఆస్పిరెంట్ ఈజ్ very good enough to understand the problems, okay, if you are good at understanding the problems, there is always a job for you, because technology can be learned, but can be trained, but thought process should be evolved. And N's question is, current AI build is built on data, is it possible without collecting more data? No, if I don't know Mr. N, I cannot predict about write about Mr. N. Yeah, I want to share you one thing. Yeah, is it real that 2100 humans go extinct? It's completely myth. Ad enduku vachindo kuda naku teliyadu. Yeah, one last thing I want to show you before we go from here. Can you see? So instead of Zoom, WebEx, Google Meet, Microsoft Teams, all this proprietary, you can simply use a big blue button, Jitsi. Okay, these are two alternatives for all those four applications. So you can suggest your faculty, you can suggest your classmates, friends to hang out on all these kind of safe applications. Okay, we are going to release a series of posters of such things. Can I close this? Yeah. So you can follow the Swecha AP pages on Instagram and all the other Twitter, Facebook and all. You all this. Why Big Blue Button is better than Zoom? So again, Nitin, I wanted to address this point on the data and internet surveillance, data privacy session. That's we are going to plan before October 2nd. In this Software Freedom Day, we wanted the community to know, or all our friends to know, the importance of free software, why it is important, okay, and how it is better than the other things. So Mr. N is asking, can you suggest some principles how the world works with only free software? So if I have to go to some other place, I cannot go like this. I need to travel a lot of kilometers, okay? So in that process, free software, okay, on the four principles it started from, that's freedom to use or freedom to run. Next, the freedom to share or distribute, the freedom to modify, and the freedom to distribute the modified one. These are the four principles that the world has to follow during the process of adopting free software. That's not going to be easy. See, meeru indaka summer camp video chusaru kada, people who inspired chusaru, then summer camp ki invite chesina students vallandaru ivvala chaala companies lo vallu developers kinda set ayyaru gaani, they are once the students of Swecha, and now they are volunteers of Swecha. And then the third video, you have seen lot of team gathering activities. Okay, andaru kinda kurchuntunnaru, evo chestunnaru, ivanni enti ante, building free software community is not an easy task. It involves lot of challenges, because different people with different mindsets come into a place. you need to make them everybody own the problem the same how much you own. ఈ సమస్య నాదే కాదు నీది కూడా అని వాడికి చెప్తే దెన్ ద వర్క్ విల్ గో గుడ్. Anithin, what is with lot of patience? Yeah, Sumam's question between Nitin answer. According to you, will our life be private in upcoming future or will it go public? Actually, నేను నా మాస్టర్ డిగ్రీ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు ఒక రీసెర్చ్ చేస్తున్నాను అన్నమాట. IPv4, IPv6 అండ్ రెండు ఐపీ అడ్రస్లు ఉంటాయి. IPv4 ఏంటంటే లిమిటెడ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ సెట్ ఉంటాయి, అవి అందరికీ ఉండవు. సో ఇంటర్నెట్లో వాడే వాళ్ళకి ఇన్ని నెంబర్లనే ఉంటాయి. IPv6 ఏంటంటే మన వరల్డ్ పాపులేషన్లో ప్రతి ఒక్కరికి ఒక ఐపీ అడ్రస్ ఇచ్చేయచ్చు, అన్ని ఎక్కువ రేంజ్ ఆఫ్ నంబర్స్ ఉంటాయన్నమాట. సో అది జరుగుతున్నప్పుడు నాకు మంచిదే కదా, ఎవ్రీబడి కెన్ రన్ దేర్ ఓన్ వెబ్సైట్. బట్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఈస్ ఇఫ్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ నాట్ అవేర్ అబౌట్ ది సర్వేలెన్స్ అండ్ డేటా ట్రాకింగ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ ఆన్ ది ప్రొప్రైటరీ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ దట్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్ నౌ. యువర్ లైఫ్ ఈస్ పబ్లిక్, యూఆర్ గివింగ్ అ విండో ఫర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ది ప్రొప్రైటరీ పీపుల్ టు అబ్జర్వ్ యూ. సో ఇట్ విల్ గో పబ్లిక్ ఇఫ్ you are not maintaining the standards of or philosophy of the free software. You are going to open yourself, your complete character to the public. Everybody must should stand, then all will go. Yeah, that's the challenge. Oka team ni build chestana process lo nee motivation perugutundi, alage vaala motivation kuda perugutha untadi. What's the most popular programming language used in AI? See, AI is a method. Aa method ni you implement cheyadaniki Python programming language ni vaadtaru. How to make our lives private? So private kanna I answer to your questions like how to make our life more secure. That we'll plan in a session in the next coming days, the data security and internet surveillance. I'll clear Sumant and Nitin about your questions in those sessions. How can we see the next 20 years with free software? Will it survive before corporates like Google, etc.? So for that question, who is responsible to protect the free software? Uma or N? Yes. So if we grow as individuals and also we grow as team, no, but no MNC is bigger than our community. Okay. So what is the most demanded specialization in CSC? It changes in the market. But for Sridevi kind of questions, I mean Sri Umadevi kind of questions, I would like to answer. If you are good at understanding the problems, okay, not the problems of binary search tree, ante mi andariki em gurtu vastadi da lo ledante ds lo program gurtu vastundi ala meeku gurtu vastundi meeku job raadu. Binary search tree meeku meer chustani world ki ela upayogapadtadi, real time example ante real time lo dinni ela apply cheyochu anna vision meeku enable aithe, you are the most demanded person for a job for any company with any kind of skill. Yeah, we started it 73 minutes ago, but the session is about to end in 60 minutes. So you still have any questions? Absolutely not, Mamata. Ads are not just the only way to make money by free software developers. Free software developers has to ban the ads. Ads ఎప్పుడు వేస్తారు, నీ డేటా ట్రాక్ చేసి నీకు ఇదంటే ఇష్టం అంటే ఆ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ స్పెసిఫిక్ యాడ్ వేస్తాను కదా, దట్ మీన్స్ యు ఆర్ బీయింగ్ ట్రాక్డ్ బై దట్ అప్లికేషన్. యువర్ డేటా, యువర్ యాక్టివిటీస్ ఆర్ ట్రాక్డ్ బై దట్ అప్లికేషన్. ఓకే, సో వాచ్ స్నోడెన్ ట్రైలర్ ఇన్ యూట్యూబ్. స్నోడెన్, SNOWDEN. యూ వుడ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ మోర్ ఆల్ ద థింగ్స్. యా, so I think we'll end it here, but we'll end the discussion like this in live mode. We can continue these discussions in our Swecha pages, or we are on social media, right? So social media is 24/7 up and running. So we can do discussions there. You can message the questions, you can post the question on the pages, you can get a response. Okay, so see you then. See you in the next celebration event. This celebration has been very interesting for me. Not the number of people, but the quality of the people you are attended here and asking the questions. 74 minutes class ena tarvata kuda question adutunnarante mee patience kasla hats off. I mean, this shows the sign of your interest towards the free software and growing along with the free software. You are most welcome to that. And the data related and most exciting talks are there and coming on the way by Swecha Andhra Pradesh to all of you. So stay tuned to Swecha AP, all the pages. Okay. Shall we end the session?